What's up, my friends? Welcome back. Today I have an experiment for you. I recently acquired a DLP printer, the FL Sun Model S, but also the Spark Maker, and I reviewed those printers. But I had the idea to try and etch a PCB using these kind of printers. I would only use the UV light of the printer to create the mask for the PCB and then etch it using acid for copper PCBs, just as always. I've made an experiment in order to see the final quality given by the resolution of the DLP printer display. This is a new method, and I couldn't find any video using this technique on YouTube. So we will see what we need, how to create the mask, and then etch the PCB and see the final layer quality and the resolution. Before we start, make sure to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell in order to see my future videos, and also thanks to all my Patreons. So guys, let's get started! What's up, my friends, welcome back! This is what we need for this experiment. First of all, of course, a DLP printer that will create a design for our PCB using UV light. I will use the FL Sun Model S. We will need some copper boards and some dry photosensitive film. Make sure to keep the film in the black plastic cover. We also need some sodium carbonate and some sodium presulfate. I know these names sound fancy, but don't worry, I will put some links below for each one of these elements. They are not expensive at all, and you could buy those from eBay. Make sure you will also have some latex gloves, and that's very important. Also 3 plastic buckets and an iron. So let's begin. The process has 4 stages. First, we will apply the dry photosensitive film to the PCB. Then we expose the PCB to UV light and the circuit design that we want. Then we clean the non-exposed film, and finally we etch the PCB with some sodium presulfate. But to use the DLP printer, I first need a file to print. For that, I go to EasyEDA, which is the platform that I use for my PCB designs. And by the way, if you want professional made PCBs in just a couple of days, use the services of the sponsor of this video, JLC PCB. They offer a lot of services, including one that's perfect for fast PCB prototyping. For only $2, you could order 10 professional made PCBs of 10x10 cm. Manufacturing time is just a couple of days, and for $6 more, I received those boards in Spain in just 7 days. So for that, go to jlcpcb.com. So back to our experiment. I've made this test PCB in EasyEDA, and I made sure that the board is 16x14 mm. I save the file, and now I go to File, Export, and select SVG file. I select the 2.5 size because the bigger is the FVG size, the better will be the STL file quality. I select only the top layer and click export. That will download this SVG file. And using this, now I have to create the STL 3D printing file. The FL Sun printer accepts SVG files as well, but for some reason it always told me that the size is too big, so I decided to go with STL files. Now you will need this software called Blender, which by the way is free. A link for this platform is provided below. Install it and open Blender. Go to File and select Import, and here select the Scalable Vector Graphic or SVG, and import the downloaded file. So here is my design. But as you can see, each part of the design is separated from the others. So to merge them together, maintain press the control keyboard, and then with the left mouse button, select all the parts. Now press control J, and that will merge all the parts together. Now we have only one vector, but this is not a 3D mesh. So for that, type Alt and the C keyboard, and select create mesh from curve. Now this is a 3D file, but it has only one layer, and I want more. For that, press Tab and go into Edit mode. Make sure you select the Vertex mode, and again maintain the Control keyboard and select all the vertices. Now press the 1 keyboard, and by that go to the front view. Now press the E keyboard for extrude, and extrude the file a few millimeters upwards. Press Tab and exit the Edit mode, and there you have it. We now have a 3D printable file of our circuit. You could change the material color if you want. Now select the object, click File, Export, and export it as an STL file. But before we print, there is one more step. We have to check the size and if we have any error. For that I will use NetFab, which by the way is also free. Link for that is below. Open NetFab and import the created file. So as you can see, it has no errors, but if it had, click this repair button and repair those small errors. Now, as you can see here, the X size is 1.2 mm. But I know that my board has a width of 60 mm, so I have to scale up the object. By which amount? Well, 1 divided by 1.2 mm multiplied by 60. That gives me 50, so I will scale up the object 50 times. Right click on the object and select scale. Type 50 and press enter, and now the file is 60 by 40 mm, just as my board size. Now save the file onto the SD card and insert that into the DLP printer. Now here I select that file. Now I go into the slicing file and here I select the exposure time of the first layer to 50,000 milliseconds or around 8 minutes. That should be enough. I press start and there you go. We can see the layer of our circuit with UV light, even the fine 0.1 mm line. So now, let's prepare the board. This is a dry, photosensitive film. You could directly buy the PCB that already has this film on it, but if not, this 2-meter roll only costs around $2. So cut the PCB to the required size. Place it over the film and cut a part just a little bit bigger than the PCB on one side. We will see why later. Cover back the photoresist film and make sure you don't have direct sunlight while working. The film will turn into dark blue when exposed to UV light, as you can see here in this example with a UV flashlight. The film has two protective layers, one on each side. For now, we only have to remove one. I use two bits of scotch tape on one corner and easily remove the protective layer. Place the film with the exposed layer onto the PCB and make sure it gets well fixed in place, and also make sure you leave a bit outside of the board. Now, in order to glue the film onto the PCB, I've used another PCB and the iron. Place the other PCB on top and hit it with the iron for around 10 seconds. Now the film is evenly glued in place onto the PCB. It's time to expose the layer of the circuit. I start the DLP printer as before, and I place the PCB onto the UV light and I leave it there for around 8 minutes. When finished, this is what we have. The circuit layer with dark blue. That means that the film was exposed. Now you could remove the top protective layer. That's why I left this tiny bit of film on the exterior of the PCB. Now it's time to clean out the unexposed photosensitive film. For that I get two plastic buckets with some warm water. From now on, make sure you wear latex gloves and protect your eyes. I put a spoon of sodium carbonate in one of the buckets and I leave the other with just water for later cleaning. Insert the PCB into the solution and in a few seconds you will see that the non-exposed area of the resin will go away. Rub it till the blue film will go away and then clean it into warm water. This is it, the PCB with the circuit mask over. Looks perfect, all I can see is this small cut here and I think that is because some dust got under the photosensitive film. It's now time to etch the copper and see the results. In another bucket we have to mix water and the sodium presulfate. This is an environmental PCB etchant. It's not as fast as the ferric chloride, but it will work just fine and it is less dangerous. I put the presulfate into warm water. When it dissolved, put the PCB into water and start moving the bucket. In a few minutes you will see that the copper will go away and all we are left with is our circuit. The water will slowly turn blue while the copper is removed. Keep moving the water so the copper will go evenly. And that's it! Clean the board with water and let's see the results. Actually, I'm really impressed by the final results. Even the 0.1 mm track turned out more or less okay. I never achieved this good resolution with the transfer method. To remove the blue mask, just use some acetone and take out the remaining film and the PCB is ready. Here we have a track of 0.1 mm up to 0.7 mm. The rest of the tracks, like for example this here for the Atmega chip, are 0.2mm and they look perfect. I could even get a 0402 size resistor, and that is really small. So I'm happy with these results. I'm sure that with more tests I could get even better. Here I have the pins for a 555 timer, and here for 8-peak SOIC chip. And here we also have the Atmega 328 chip. I've also made the board for the Arduino that I've made with my CNC mill. As you can see, it turned out great. Just a small error here, and that's easy to fix. As you can see, the board is way more cleaner than the one made with the CNC mill. The tracks of this board are 0.3mm thick and turn out great. Even these small SMD components. I've also made the top layer of an Arduino Nano, but I didn't etch that out, since making a double layer for this board was very difficult. And that's the problem, if you want double layer board, it is almost impossible to overlap the layers on top of each other, but I will try that in the future. So there you have it, it is possible to expose circuits on PCB using DLP printers, and also get good results. Now I know that I could make homemade prototypes even with SMD components, since as we have seen before, the SMD components turn out great. Try using always at least 0.2mm track. Below that you might get errors. Check more information and more photos on my webpage electronoobs.com. I hope that this project was interesting and that you have learned something new. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell in order to see future videos. And also click the like button like crazy and share this video with your friends. And remember, if you consider helping my projects, check my Patreon page as well. Thanks again and see you later, guys.